Hey, this is Ralph, and where we last left off was I just inserted a few images onto my web page. I'm going to go ahead and jazz these up a little bit by messing with the CSS. All three of my images are contained within figure tags, and those also have some fig captions, so I'm going to go ahead and format those a bit. Let's see, I'll go ahead and change the width to 250. By the way, when you just change the width of an image, it will change the height proportionally. And if you just change the height, it will change the width proportionally. So go ahead and do that. And I'm going to say all of my figures are going to have a thin border with a little border radius and a little padding. So I'm just changing the characteristics of the figure tags, and the figure tags contain my images. So just do a few changes here at a time, check them out and see how they go. And you can see that my figure tags are taking up the full width available to them. That is a behavior of a block element. So whenever you stick a border on something, you see it goes all the way across, or background color by the way, that's an obvious sign that it's a block element, as opposed to an image. Check this out real quick. I did a, I picked solid red on the images. Notice how the border just hugs the image itself. That's an indication of an inline element. Okay, so I'll go ahead and change this to black. So I've got a black border on the images, and for these figures I will go ahead and set the width to 260 pixels. And let's see, I'll do a little, one thing at a time. So let's, so you can see what this will look like. There we go. So my figures are smaller now. In fact, if they were a little bit bigger, there we go, a little bit wider. And if I want to center, now I can put text align center. Now I'm doing text align center for my figures. And this is, ultimately, it will center my text, by the way, but it's actually going to center my image also. An inline image is treated just like text. So when I refresh this, you'll notice my image will get centered within that light bluish border. There we go. Image is centered. And then I can also go ahead and let's back over to my editor. Fig caption. And refresh. There we go. So now we've got some information on here that makes it a little bit easier to look at. I'm going to do something I think will look a little bit better. I'm going to get rid of this padding. Don't like the look of that. There we go. One of those borders to hug in there a little bit better. And I'm also going to add some the border radius to my fig caption. Excellent. So now we've got this going on. All right, so now I've got these figures and the fig captions. Let me go ahead and set a little margin. And I will float these to the left. That'll get them side by side, if they could have fit. So now I've got my images. They're inside of their figures. They have fig captions. And now we can clearly see how these images are being displayed and manipulated just by putting them inside of a block element. Now, I didn't have to use fig caption at all. Could have used paragraphs, could have used divs. All would have worked pretty much the same. Let's try something a little bit different. I'm going to put my image here as part of a background to this headline one. So let's see, I'm going to head over to my headline one, create a rule for it in my styles, and I'll do a text align center, and I'm going to set a height on it also of 100 pixels, and then I'll do a background image. I need images/moon.jpg, that makes more sense. Okay, so I'm going to insert this moon image as a background image for my headline one. and refresh. There we go. And it's actually working. You just really can't tell because the moon image is bigger than my space available. So let's try a couple things just so it stands out to you that it's working. I'm going to change the text color of my headline one. So you can actually see that I do have some text up there. But I'd also like to be able to see this moon image. So let me show you something real quick. I'm going to take my background size and I'll change it over to 20%. This will be pretty shocking, so it'll stand out to you. There we go. So now that my background image is so small, you can clearly see where it is. Now I can also take the next step of, all right, well, I'm going to say background repeat, no repeat. Okay, making sense. There's one moon, but I really like that color back there, so I'll do a background color of black to kind of fill that all in.